such a focus on third downs throughout training camp, preseason, it still reared its ugly head. What was behind
it? Yeah, man. I mean, obviously early in the game, that third and six in the red zone, Kyler got out and Pop found his way in the back of the end zone, and they connected. Tough one there. The other ones that I can remember, like, I mean, I felt like we challenged for the most part and were in position. I felt like they made some plays, good throws, good catches. Hopefully we can find ways to make a few more of those plays instead of them, right? I think a couple of those things showed up at times. The third and long scramble, right? Like, he got away. We lost our guy in the back end, didn't stay with our guy on the scramble. He ended up finding him there. So, I mean, for the most part, I felt like we were close, you know. I felt like we were able to get some pressure. But the scrambles and then them making some good plays on us when I felt like KB was tight, right? KB was tight. I think those things kind of showed up in the stats.
On the second and five touchdown to Hopkins, that seems like the kind of play we've been talking about all preseason. You sent six. Every DB is behind sticks and off. Byard's 8 yards away from Hopkins when he touches the ball. That's the kind of play you said. You're going to challenge, you're going to challenge, you're going to challenge. And everybody was on.
Yeah, that was the empty one, right, in the high red. Yeah, I think, I mean, when we game plan and we try to do some things, especially in regards to some of the empty formations, like, it's a fine line between do you show your hand or do you try to disguise with some other things we've been playing the empty throughout the game, right? Ideally, when you blitz zero, you want to be able to be tight. Hopefully, if they throw that one, we can come up and get it on the ground, right? But I think there's a fine line between always being there and showing your hand and then having the ability to also kind of complement that look and do some different things, right? And, I mean, second and five, I think that's a lot different than third and five, in my opinion, too. You know what I'm saying? And I think as it relates to the call, too, does that make sense, Paul? But it was one of those scenarios. We were off. We weren't really up in the line of scrimmage. We weren't really showing blitz zero out the jump, right? And then they ended up side adjusting, made a quick throw. We didn't get our hands up, and then we missed the tackle.
So it fired him the right, like, spot on that play.
Yeah. And then Hopkins made a play, right? Made a miss. And
challenge this week in some way similar quarterback, and maybe how is it maybe even greater with the veteran in Wilson?
Yeah, I think there's similarities in their skill set. I mean, obviously Russell's done it at a high level for a really long time, right? He had a great week last week. I think close to 80% throwing the ball. Again, played a lot of football, has seen it all from anything we're going to throw at him defensively. I think the biggest thing for us, man, we got to continue to find ways to affect the quarterback, and we got to continue to find ways to stay tight, right? And it's that fine line, being able to complement each other and do those things. But it is going to be a big challenge for us, especially with those guys they got in the perimeter as well. But looking forward to the opportunity to get back out there and kind of see where it goes.
How do you assess Bud Dupree's play this past Sunday? And is that, speaking of fine lines, tough sometimes when you got a guy coming off of an ACL, first game action in a while?
Yeah, absolutely. I do. I think first time really getting into it where it's 100% full go to the ground, the whole shebang. I do think it's a little – there's an adjustment period, right? But I think he'll keep improving. I think the him getting more comfortable with what we're doing defensively, right, and his role and the style. And, I mean, it's tough too, man. You're dealing with a Kyler Murray-type player, so that kind of plays into it a little bit schematically and just individually. I think that is in their mind a little bit too. But I do hope to see improvement as this thing goes and he gets more adjusted to actually getting back out there.
Christian Fulton had a couple, you know, nice pass breakups and seemed to be pretty consistent. How would you assess his play on Sunday?
Yeah, man, I was very encouraged with him. I thought he challenged. I thought he was tight. I felt like he took a step in the right direction from what he's kind of been showing here at camp and going through things. It was good to see him get out there and actually play with that confidence and be able to be close on those guys and make some plays on the ball when it was in the air. So I'm encouraged with where he's at. He's got to continue, man. Each day out here at practice, he's just got to continue to keep pressing to improve. Like, the consistency always, day in and day out, and then being able to carry that through on Sunday, which he did last week.
How much you hated for, I guess, Amani, who had kind of earned the spot, and now with Bradley, does he give you a guy that that you feel good about because of his experience and his knowledge of what they do?
Yeah, I mean, it's tough for Imani. I mean, I hate it for him. I do. As you guys heard 1,000 times, it's next man up, whether it's Bradley, whether it's Dane, whether it's Farley, right? It's next man up. Those guys got to be ready to go. And then we got to kind of see how it plays out, right, as the game's going, how those guys are fitting, how they're handling everything. But excited for those guys' opportunity to go out there and play and make some plays. And they got some shoes to fill, right, because Hook was doing some good things here. It's good to have Byard back there to kind of help with whoever's in there. But looking forward to seeing those guys go.
Are you saying you maybe do a little more situationally then instead of just these are our two safeties and we're going with them?
Yeah, I think based on how the game's going, how they're doing, right, depending on that, I think that's going to play a role. We're just going to have to keep an eye on them and see how it goes throughout. Third down package will come into play just with where we're using guys and the pieces there. Like, that will affect it too. But I think we just got to see how they're doing as the game's going on.
More speed in the slot these days in the NFL. Is that one of the things Elijah's going to have to adjust to here in the NFL is getting some of that great speed in the in
yeah
the-
and I think always with that position, you got to understand where your help's coming from, right? Like, more times than not you're going to have a piece somewhere, but understanding where the help's coming from. But those guys are fast, they're shifty, like, they're hard. It's hard to cover those guys. It is. But I think just understanding the scheme and how he can use the scheme to kind of use it to his advantage when he's put in those positions to have to cover those guys.
Like a TD pass, is that perhaps something you reference?
Yes, exactly. Like, same deal, just understanding what's going on and understanding and it's kind of, it goes back to a rookie understanding, being able to, in the situation, know what to expect to some degree too, right? Like, and that comes, the more experience you have, the more knowledge you have, you're not just out there truly playing and trying to execute a call. You're able to piece a lot more together the more you play, right? So I think he'll come. He's a smart kid. He works hard. It's just got to be, we got to translate that a little bit better on Sunday at times.
Conceptual understanding, position to position, guy to guy. Where are you with that?
Yeah, I think it's pretty good. I mean, there were a handful of MAs, but overall, I thought the guys were pretty locked in. It goes, and to me, like, the conceptual understanding part, very similar to what I was just talking about with Elijah. Like, I got to know what the guy next to me is doing because it's going to affect my job. Whatever they throw at me, like, knowing what the guy next to me, how he's going to fit, how he's going to play this route, like, knowing that stuff within the concept, whether it's man, whether it's cover two, cover three, cover four, like, that can only further enhance my understanding of kind of how to get my job done based on what we're seeing.
Expected Autry to maybe get some more snaps than he did, and what'd you think of his performance, Autry?
Autry, yeah, I mean, I thought he did a good job when he was out there. I mean, it's good. We're able to rotate those guys and hopefully keep them fresh.